Hi there, I'm Mike Gales for Fight Your Way Fit, and 6 weeks ago I posted a video titled The Time Is Now. And in that video I explained that people often want to get in shape for summer, usually for July 4th weekend. The problem is that they wait until a week or so before to start actually trying to get in shape, and that's usually just a little bit too late. Also, there's so much misinformation out there that can make it quite confusing for people to get into great shape, even if they take an entire year. And so I like to do videos like this one to show that it doesn't have to be mysterious and there is no big secret. In fact, it could be quite simple. And so here we can take a look at 6 weeks ago when I posted that video on March 18th. And I actually filmed this footage on March 13th. So you can see right away that I definitely put on weight. Now the actual number of pounds doesn't really matter or make a difference because I could easily manipulate the scale. But for reference, I would say that I gained about 20 pounds. But more importantly, just notice that my muscles are flat from not working out, and then my abs are completely covered with a layer of fat. And oh, how did I get this way? Well, I stopped working out so I wasn't burning as much calories, and I started to eat a lot more. And literally right after I shot that video in March, we got hit with a big snowstorm here in Canada, where I was outside pushing my car in the snow because I got stuck and I slipped and twisted my ankle. And yeah, I twisted it pretty bad and that thing just swelled right up. And we're gonna get to why I'm telling you this in just a moment. I shot this footage on the 19th of April. So that was just over 5 weeks that I had to get back in shape. And you can see that I definitely lost a bit of fat. Not only that, but my muscles look fuller and they look harder. Now this was way too short of a period to gain any new muscle. I just look better because my muscles have a little more blood flow going to them and they're a little more toned. Why? Because I actually started using them again. So I do look better, but most importantly, I feel infinitely better. But to be honest, I haven't yet reached my goal. I still have a few more percentage points of fat to lose to look like my usual self again. And just as a frame of reference, I said I wanted to lose 20 pounds and I probably lost about 15. So I have another 5 pounds to go to look really nice and ripped. And so the main point that I want to emphasize to you with this video is that there is still time. We are only at the end of April, so you still have enough time between now and July 4th to do something to see a noticeable difference. I also mentioned in my last video that I was going to follow a certain routine, that I was going to do the heavy bag for beginners as my cardio, along with some jogging on the treadmill to warm up. And I would also be lifting some weights from my upper and lower body for the first 3 weeks. That's why I mentioned that I twisted my ankle. You see, here I had this big swollen ankle that stopped me from training the way that I wanted to. I also had 2 young kids. My foster mother was sick with pneumonia over the winter and I was constantly driving back and forth to the city to check on her. I had that and probably 10 other excuses not to train. Yet it's always a choice. So I had the choice to sit around and continue to do nothing, or I had the choice to adapt and perhaps try and do something a little different. So anything such as running was out of the question, as well as standing up to lift weights. So for the first 3 weeks, all I did for cardio was the beginner's heavy bag routine with no movement. I just stood there and threw the shots in place. As for my resistance training, I decided that I would use some resistance bands to work my way back into it as my ankle was healing. And I'll leave links below to the resistance band routine along with the heavy bag routine. I also followed that simple ab routine that I just posted, and I did that about 3 days a week. And so I guess my point is that yes, to all of us, things happen, but something is always better than nothing. And for those first 3 weeks, I definitely had to alter my program. So was I having 5 days a week of these amazing workouts? No, but I was getting some blood flow going to those muscles, which is definitely a lot better than just sitting on the couch watching TV. And as for my diet, I followed the sneaky diet, and there's a link in the description below. But once again, I didn't follow it that strictly. You see, I had a bunch of birthdays one after the other. And of course I love cake, so yes, here and there I did cheat on that diet. So I definitely wasn't following that diet strictly 7 days a week, but I was watching what I eat perhaps 70 to 75% of the time. And that's a lot better than continuously overeating. And right now you may be thinking to yourself, why is this guy telling me this? Well, I want to focus on a few points that perhaps a lot of trainers may just gloss over. Number one being, does your diet always have to be super strict to see results? No. And number two, do you have to be killing yourself so hard in the gym that you're barely able to walk after? Once again, no. When it comes to both your health and your physique, something is always better than nothing. And you are always going to be way better off with a routine that you can actually stick to, or at least somewhat stick to, than some ridiculous routine where you're killing yourself and you want to quit within a day or so. So if you want to look and feel better for this summer, well, we're only at the end of April. Well, there's still time for you to start doing something now so that you can see a noticeable difference by the time we hit July. You also don't need to be doing anything super crazy or super strict. And so I'm going to give you just a little bit of a recap of what I did over the past 5 weeks. Number one, I switch all of my drinks to water. Why? Because it's a simple, easy way to cut calories. Next, when I did train, I tried as much as possible to focus on hitting larger muscle groups. That way I can maximize both my time and my effort. And I'll leave links to what I did in the description below. And so 6 weeks ago, I told you guys that I wanted to start training 5 days a week. And because of circumstances, I had to definitely miss a few workouts. But am I worried about it? No, not really. I didn't achieve my goal. I'm perhaps 5 pounds away, but there's still time. Never mind about looking better. Now that I'm actually starting to feel better and to get into better shape, soon I'll start posting up some new boxing videos and training videos to help you guys get into the greatest shape possible. Until then, this has been Mike Gales for Fight Your Way Fit. And as always, I thank each and every one of you for watching.